LaBernard. Before going into the video, you need to grab the free dog training secrets guide in which we have disclosed the deepest dog training secrets that professional dog trainers don't want you to know about. These training secrets would help you have a well-behaved, super intelligent, smart, and obedient dog without spending hundreds of dollars. So make sure to check the first link in our description to the free video series guide. Now let's get into today's video. Height, 25 to 32 inches. Weight, 80 to 150 pounds. Lifespan, 8 to 12 years. Group, not applicable. Best suited for seasoned dog owners who can commit time for exercise, families with kids, owners who live in a house with a fenced yard. Temperament, loving, loyal, protective, gentle. Comparable breeds, Saint Bernard, Labrador Retriever. LaBernard basics. The LaBernard is a hybrid of the easygoing Labrador Retriever and the gentlest of giant dogs, the Saint Bernard. In spite of this placid lineage, he's a big boy that can have a mind of his own and requires regular exercise to expend some of his energy and a firm hand when it comes to training. His ideal owner is someone with the time and patience needed to bring out the best in this dog and who has experience raising larger breeds. The LaBernard is a hybrid of the easygoing Labrador Retriever and the gentlest of giant dogs, the Saint Bernard. Origin. The LaBernard is considered a designer dog and likely dates back 30 to 40 years when demand for a smaller format of the large breed dog first took off. Although he may be a recent addition to the world of dogs, the LaBernard comes from seasoned stock that includes the Labrador Retriever, who dates back to 19th century Newfoundland, Canada, where he was used by fishermen to haul nets, ropes and pull in fish, and the Saint Bernard, who rumor has it, came from breeding native dogs with giant Asian molossers during the first 2 centuries AD. Pedigree. As a hybrid, the LaBernard does not qualify to join the American Kennel Club's, AKC, roster of purebreds. His parents, however, have both achieved AKC status. The Labrador Retriever was admitted to the club sporting group back in 1917 and is described as active, friendly and outgoing. The Saint Bernard became a member of the working group in 1885 and is considered friendly, patient and outgoing. The LaBernard's parents both achieved AKC status. The Labrador Retriever was admitted to the club's sporting group back in 1917, and the Saint Bernard became a member of the working group in 1885. Food, diet. The LaBernard is a large-sized dog that will consume up to 3 to 4 cups of dry food daily. Kibble size should be large, to slow gobbling, and should be geared specifically to his age and activity level. Always choose food that lists meat as a first ingredient and avoid fillers such as carbohydrates and grains that will make him want to overeat in order to feel full. As both the Labrador Retriever and Saint Bernard are prone to hip dysplasia and joint issues, foods that include glucosamine are a good option. Because Labs are also known to overeat whenever they can, and Saint Bernards can suffer from bloat, don't plan to free feed your dog or exercise immediately after feeding. Training. The LaBernard can be a handful when it comes to training and may require the support of a professional trainer or obedient school if you aren't an experienced dog owner. Patience will be needed with this big boy, as well as time and perseverance, but he's a great dog and when fully trained and socialized will be a great addition to any family. Adapt a positive, rewards-based approach to his training, with firm, consistent instructions followed by lots of praise and your choice of reward. Weight. The LaBernard is considered a very large-sized breed and when fully grown, will weigh 80 to 150 pounds depending on whether you have a male or a female. Temperament, behavior. The LaBernard can be a handful when it comes to training. Both the Saint Bernard and the Labrador Retriever are known for being patient, gentle dogs who rate high on the obedience scale. Similarly, the LaBernard's friendly, intelligent personality and alert, protective nature make him a perfect family dog or even a great candidate for a service dog. While he can be willful and require a professional trainer, once he's on the right path he will be an awesome pet. Common health problems. Although the ailments that plague purebred dogs may completely bypass your hybrid, be sure to do your homework to understand what health issues he may in fact have inherited. For both Labrador Retrievers and Saint Bernards, hip and elbow dysplasia are a common problem, with the Saint Bernard also being very susceptible to gastric torsion, bloat, as well as bone and joint issues. Life expectancy. The LaBernard has a life expectancy of 8 to 12 years. Exercise requirements. The LaBernard is a very active dog that will require substantial exercise and is best suited to an owner or family who enjoys outdoor fitness activities such as running, hiking or jogging. As with most energetic breeds, a lack of exercise can result in depression and boredom that can turn into destructive behavior. Ideally, his owner will have a fenced yard where a ball can be tossed and this big boy can enjoy some active playtime to augment his walks and keep him mentally stimulated. Coat. The Labernard's fur is short and dense, with a thick double coat. His coloring can range from white, yellow, brown and tan to black or red and often includes markings similar to those of a Saint Bernard. He is considered a moderate shedder, which means brushing up to 3 times per week in order to keep the hair in check. Because he is a floppy-eared dog, he can run into issues with moisture, wax buildup, so you should be checking and cleaning his ears weekly to avoid infection. Puppies. Large breed dog puppies grow rapidly and pet owners need to be extremely careful about their diet. Providing them with the right nutrition is critical, as studies show that free feeding or overfeeding your pup high energy foods that may include excess calcium can result in osteochondrosis, an orthopedic disease that can occur in fast growing dogs, particularly large breeds such as Great Danes, Newfoundlands, and Saint Bernard. Puppies can't properly absorb the added calcium and it can impact bone growth. Consult with your vet or breeder about the best diet for your little guy. And don't forget to check out the free video series that teaches the quick and easy way to an obedient dog, so make sure to get yours by clicking the first link in the description. If you like the video, then make sure to hit that like button. Also, if you want more dog training, guides, information, then make sure to subscribe to our channel. Let me know what you think of this video in the comments and thank you for watching. And please consider subscribing our channel for more about dog training and dog breeds content every day.